It was at Gethsemane that the Bible says that he said to them, sit here while I go over there to pray. Meaning that Gethsemane, in Gethsemane, even though there is a crowd, the experience is private. Every man who visits Gethsemane, there may be many people who in their own prophetic journey, they are also in Gethsemane. But our experiences will never be the same. Every man's crushing is different. What God needs to bring out of your life will determine how hard he will crush you. If what he wants to bring out of your life is going to feed nations, your crushing might last years. God is never in a hurry to announce a man. He is more concerned about the process than the destination. So he can keep a man in Gethsemane for as long as it takes. For Jesus, it took hours. For certain men like Paul, it took him years in the wilderness of Arabia. It was when the crushing had finished in Arabia that God felt that Paul was ready for his voice to be heard in the tabernacles of men. So even though many of us are coming to the tent and many men are praying, can I announce to you, bro, the crushing experience is a private experience. There are things that will happen in the dark places of your room that you can't share with another man. It's an experience that only you and God will live to know. So he said, sit here while I go yonder. Notice that the others were not invited into the process. The others were just told, I'm going to pray. That is to tell you that in the walk, in the dealings of God, they are stratas. Not everybody is privileged to be called into the bedchamber of God. For some Christians, till they die, God will never step out of the shadows. He will never reveal himself to them. Because God is not in a hurry to throw his pearls before swine. He must find that there is something in your heart that is more pressing to you, that is not as pressing to you as the revelation of himself. That means you must come to the place where you want God more than you want to live. You want him more than you even want life. He said, watch with me. They were called and given unusual access. And with that kind of access, they slept. Even though they desire to change the story, they cannot. That season has what? Has passed. They had a chance for it to be written concerning them that in that day of his anguish, three men watched with him. But they allowed that season to pass. And you see, in the realm of the spirit, there are certain seasons that cannot be recovered. God can forgive you and show you mercy, but he can't turn back the hand of the clock. You could not tarry for 1 hour. The hidden statement in that phrase was, what will you do when I have ascended? How will you cope when I'm no longer here for you to run to and ask, who sees?